Heidi ho, folks. Whew. Kind of a weird video today because I'm gonna do this combination. I'm gonna give you a WIP update with some haul now and then. For those of you who like to watch my vlog series right after this in the same video, like it's gonna be my vlog series for the month of January. So if you don't like the vlog isn't your thing, once I'm done with this, you can just leave. If you're more interested in the vlog than this, you can fast forward a little bit, whatever you want to do. Or you could just turn it off if I'm just not your style. I do not judge, whatever you want to do. I had something I wanted to talk about. I'm gonna run through my WIPs, and I have to burp. No, I don't. My WIPs and haul, and then maybe what I wanted to talk about or put out there will come to me. Either way, in January, I had three new starts. You've only seen one so far, I think. Unless you're on Stitchmania on Facebook, in which case you've probably seen all of them. The first was my very first hardanger project, which the lovely and gracious Nina of Stitching with a Smile so kindly helped me out and provided me a pattern, and she's got her wonderful little instructional video series, and she's a much better teacher than she thinks she is, because those things plus the books have, like, it's a perfect combination just for the way I learn. The hardanger is not done yet. All the cluster blocks are done, all the blanket stitches are done, and I did the cutting. Oh my god. That was scary. So anyway, here's where I am now. I can see you. You probably can't see me, but I can see you. So here's where it is. And it's, I finished, this was in rotation this past week. So it's getting put away for a little while, and then when I come back to it, I'm going to start some of the needle weaving. And we'll see how that goes. This is not perfect. It's not perfect by any stretch of the imagination. But I think, I mean, it's the first time I've ever done this, and I'm still pretty proud of myself. I mean, I think you can tell. I need different scissors. Like, these are my current embroidery scissors, and they work nicely. They're very good at what they do, but I don't think the blades are thin enough for hardanger. If anyone has any recommendations, I am all ears. I'm happy with this. I was gonna wax philosophical and talk about how we need to give ourselves permission to fail more. And especially those of us with children, we need to let our children know that it's okay to be bad at something. Because when you're first learning something, you're gonna be pretty terrible at it. Unless you're a savant, which hardly any of us are. So I'm being gentle with myself and my learning new crafts. Because I think it's better for me in the long run, and it sets a good example for my kid who's learning soccer. And, like, for a 5-year-old who's just learning soccer, she's doing really well. Compared to, like, Mia Hamm, she's pretty terrible. But that's okay. When you're learning something new, it's okay to be bad as long as you're learning. Even if you're not learning, whatever. Anyway, I cannot philosophize today. But that was the hardanger. So this... Sorry about that. Yeah, thanks a lot, phone. Just randomly cut me off. Great. Anyway, so that was the hardanger. Going away until its turn in the rotation comes up. So far, I'm kind of liking having this rotation thing. I know it's not for everybody. I find it really keeps my enthusiasm up for all of my projects. I limit myself to 4 WIPs going at a time, just because that's what keeps me going. That's 4 cross-stitch WIPs. I have knitting WIPs too. Okay, so you go there in the drawer. Oh, and needle minders are making everything stick together. That's lovely. Thank you. Okay, surprise new start. Well, not really a surprise new start. I decided I wanted to do it, and so I did. And actually, someone whose name I forget just finished this today and posted it on Stitch Mania, and it looks great. I'm sorry, I don't remember your name. Anyway, last year, Carolyn Mazzio did this, and I thought it was lovely, and I made it for my kid, because it reminds me of this book we used to read her a lot when she was very small. It's one of the first books we ever started reading to her. I think she was born in late November, so like it was one of her very, very first Hanukkah presents. Like, she was mere weeks old when this was given to us, and that was one of the very first things we read to her, because we read from her to her from the time she was born, because we're geeks. And it's good to do that as early as possible. Studies show. Science. Yay. Anyway, it's called Romantic Moonlight. It's from Cross Stitch Collection Magazine, February 2015. It's a little moon, and it says, "I love you to the moon and back." The book in question, by the way, is Guess How Much I Love You. For those of you who don't know, it's about bunnies. But, yeah, it's called Romantic Moonlight. I don't know that there's anything particularly romantic about it. I think it's going to be perfect for my kiddo. And this is DMC on 28 count cashel linen in cream. So I'm probably going to finish this in a hoop. Anyone who has suggestions on how to do that, I'd appreciate knowing. And let me clarify, I know how to use a hoop. I do. I'm curious about how you get the tension correct. And when I say that, I mean the instructions in the finishing instructions for this specific pattern suggest using double-sided tape. And I'm just wondering, how do you make that work as far as, like, because you have to pull the fabric taut, and won't the fabric as you're pulling it catch on the tape and things get kind of wonky? And I'm not explaining it correctly, but yeah, if anyone has any tips or can explain it in a way that makes more sense in the way that the pattern didn't, I would appreciate it. This should get finished the next time I work on it, which should be... Its turn is this coming week, actually, but I'm going to be working on a project for... the February Stitch Along in Stitch Mania. Is it called, like, We Love Cross Stitch or something like that? I'm so bad at this. Anyway, the next time I work on this, I will finish it. Plenty of time. Okay, and then I'm going to show you Master in the Macabre, were just coming along. I didn't get as much done as I'd really, really hoped I would, but I got enough that I'm still happy with the progress I am making on it. So here it is now. So I think the last time you saw it, I had not quite finished this, and I hadn't filled in here, and obviously I hadn't done the windows, the top two windows. Pleased with myself because using videos and a quick tutorial, I taught myself how to do pin stitch. I don't know why I was worried about that. It is ridiculously easy. So I did pin stitch on this little red stitch right here, and then up here in this, do you see that tiny little pale blue? Those are both pin stitch. Should I do pin stitch anywhere else? Not yet. So we also have the mask and the red death here, and the telltale heart. The French knot for the eye here is not centered, but I'm kind of okay with that because it kind of looks like instead of the eyes kind of looking off in a different direction rather than straight ahead, and I kind of like that effect. At least that's what I'm telling myself right now. But yeah, so that's the progress that got made on Mastering the Macabre this month. And yes, everybody's favorite needle minder. Every time it shows up in a video, I get compliments. Who made that? Jenna in Australia? Someone in Australia. Someone who makes needle minders in Australia who has an Etsy shop made that for me. I am the least helpful person in the world right now. I'm so sorry. Last cross-stitch whip. I started my Mirabilia. It happened. It was scary, but I did it. For those of you who don't remember what I was doing, I'm doing Autumn in My Garden by Mirabilia. And I'm doing this on, I just happen to have a little tag right here. I'm doing this on 32 count Belfast linen in flax. Big piece of fabric. Okay. So the center is, where is the center? It's like around here-ish somewhere. So I did this little leaf, and then I was like, oh, what do I do now? And I thought, well, her skirt looks nice and safe. So I counted over, and I'm working on her skirt. And from there, I will figure out. I'm just going to wing it. But I'm still alive. The pattern hasn't eaten me. Nothing catastrophic has happened. So far, so good. Yeah. So, happy stuff. Very pleased with this. So tomorrow, I'm going to be starting, well, sometime tomorrow. Depending on when the mail gets here. For the Love Stitch Along in Stitch Mania. I ordered a pattern and I kitted it up from Lizzie Kate. Carolyn Mazzio showed it in her January haul video. It's just a tiny sampler. It says, do small things with great love. I'm not a big Lizzie Kate person, but I saw that and I thought, my sister would like that. And then it's been, you know, in the back of my mind all month. And I thought, you know what, I'll just do it because I didn't have time to knit her anything. Her birthday's in March. I haven't had time to knit her anything. Last year, she got socks. Socks. Last year. The lucky little so-and-so. She appreciates hand knits so much. She can count on a lifetime supply. So anyway, tomorrow, that should arrive in the mail tomorrow. So tomorrow evening, I will probably start that. For the stitch along, so. And it should be a fairly quick stitch, so. That's what's going on the cross stitch front. I had started a baby blanket that I think I mentioned I was going to be starting. Maybe last video? Last WIP update? Where are you? There you are. Where's the yarn? Here it is. I opted to use some superwash wool from Knit Picks because honestly, you can't, I mean, it's a decent yarn, and for baby stuff, you can't go wrong with a superwash if you're doing wool. So this is Swish, which is Knit Picks superwash wool line. It's in a DK weight, and the colorway is Green Tea Heather. It looks a little brighter on the screen than it actually is. But I thought it was appropriate for a baby that's going to be born in the springtime. The pattern I am using is a digital pattern. I can link it below, by Anne Hansen. It's called Cradle Me. And I have done the bottom border and 4 repeats of the lace pattern. Can you see? I'm just gonna hope you can see. And I haven't, I've got some ends that need to be woven in. Normally I do that as I go, but I just wasn't feeling it. Got kind of on a roll. It's nice. It's an interesting pattern. It keeps me awake, but it's not so tedious that I'm like knitting slowly with like beads of sweat while staring at the pattern, making sure I don't mess it up. It's not one of those, which is nice. So this is what I've been doing in the evening. I'm not concerned about having that done by May. Not at all. So, hooray. Okay, what next? I have some haul. I know not everyone likes haul. I'm sorry. You can try and fast forward to the blog if that's something you wanted to do, or you can leave now. Really, whatever works for you. I'm not planning on doing another one of these like mashup videos. It just seemed like it made the most sense because I got very behind this month for a variety of reasons. having said that, I don't have very much haul. I have some needle minders, and through Stitchy Box, I got a Stitchy surprise pack. So that's what I got for you. There's not much. So Alan Rickman died, and I was very sad. I'm not gonna gush about how much I loved Alan Rickman. But that was tough. That was a bad day. And lovely Jeannie Frakes of Minding My Minders was doing some Rickman needle minder thing, so I had to get some. So here we have Alan Rickman as the Sheriff of Nottingham in Robin Hood, Prince of Thieves, and as Hans Gruber in Die Hard. And then here we have a Professor Snape. And then, just for fun, I got a Knit Fast, Die Warm needle minder. Because, seriously, kind of want that as a tattoo someday. So those are my needle minders. And then let's have a look at the Stitchy Surprise Pack. There's not really that much in here. I got a little special offer from, I get a percentage off of a subscription to another Stitchy Box subscription, or to Just the Threads. I'm thinking of using it for Just the Threads. But that was really nice, 15% off. Does Just the Threads have their own website? Because the last time I looked, like, signups were closed. Just putting that out there. What else? This is a Weeks Dye Works cotton floss, 2-strand cotton floss. This is weird. I have never seen this before from Weeks. It's called Whitewash, number 1091. You can't, there's a lot of glare because it's wrapped in cellophane. So it's kind of a cream, whitish cream. So that's interesting. And then this is Valdani, hand-dyed color fast, cotton floss, 10 yards in the colorway Muddy Pots. New floss is always neat. Sorry about that. Have a very precarious setup here. And then I got 2 Karen Wildflowers, which is a pearl cotton, I think. You could use it for cross stitch or for hardanger. So, just looking at it, it looks like it's the equivalent to a number, like a number 8 pearl cotton of DMC. Please correct me if I'm wrong. This one is called Sticks and Stones. And then this one is called Bordeaux. This is showing up way more purpley than it does when I sit and I look at it in my hand. Then again, it's like almost 7 o'clock at night and I've got like a little light over here and light up there, so who knows? And then last but not least, I got a little fat 8, is it a fat 8? Yeah, it's fat 16th, I'm sorry, fat 16th. Of a 32 count with Ghana in sea foam from. And the phone did it again. Where was I? 32 count with Ghana in sea foam by Hand Dyed Fabrics by Stephanie. Fat 16th. And the lighting in here is totally washing it out. But it is a very pale, it's a light seafoam green. I like it. So that'll be good to just have in the stash for, you know, something. Good to have little scraps. So that's pretty much what I got for you folks. I had wanted to ask, kind of just like, because I'm kind of fishing for what to do for new content, what do you guys want to see? Whether it's like in my vlog or in like the actual cross-stitch videos, you know, WIP updates, etc. I could talk about knitting more. I could, like, actually show knitting more. When I showed my grandfather's socks, someone had commented about how knitting the heel of a sock always confused them and they never quite got the hang of it. And so I was thinking, well, I'd be happy to film a little tutorial about just how do you turn the heel of a sock. Be happy to do that. I think it would be great fun. Do you want to see spinning? Do you want me to share some of the books I have on my shelf that are craft related most? Okay, knitting related. I don't have any cross-stitch books and I'm a self-taught spinner, so but I'd be happy to show off some of my favorites and review them and talk about them a little bit. Katie the Stash Queen and Coffee Stitcher have been sort of doing a Q&A thing. I'm more than happy to do that. I think it would be an interesting way to actually interact with people because I'm so, so bad at replying to comments. But yeah, what would you like? I mean, as far as the vlog goes, like as the weather gets nicer, I'm gonna like start filming things like my local farmer's market. I'm gonna be able to like take you into downtown Philadelphia and show you the sights and show you the cool stuff and show you, the stuff that the locals like, and just stuff, the cats, yard stuff. But yeah. What do you think is interesting? I am curious. I totally zoned out there for a second. I'm sorry. It's been a long weekend. Anyway, that's what I have for you guys right now. And if you'd like to say later now, have a wonderful stitching week coming up, month. You guys are great. Flosstube is great. In a couple of months here, I'll be coming up on my, maybe not a couple of months. I think in April of last year, I started filming Flosstube videos and I have plans for a giveaway. I'm just putting that out there, a little teaser. But this is like one of the most fun things I've ever done. So, thanks for coming along for the ride. So if you're not gonna watch the vlogs that are tacked onto the end of this, have a great one. If you are, have a great one anyway, but I'll say that at the end of the vlog video too. So, okay, take care everybody. Happy New Year. It is Tuesday, January 5th. First little vlog clip of the year. It is freaking cold in Philadelphia today. Remember, I had said that it was unseasonably warm, in mid-December, and it was really cold this morning. It was well below freezing. I'd say about 20 degrees below freezing this morning. But it's supposed to be a lot like springtime temperatures by the end of the week. So yeah, that's global warming for you. I got some new stuff going on. You probably already saw my hardanger video, and honestly I'm planning on doing this through the month, so by the time I post this, who knows, the hardanger project might be complete. But here, let's see if I can, there we go. Uh The blanket stitches are giving me a hell of a time. So I'm taking a little sanity break. And starting something new. My fabric came in finally, and I am starting work on Romantic Moonlight, which can be found in the February 2015 issue of Cross Stitch Collection magazine. And this is only like half an hour or so's worth of stitching. DMC on this is 28 count cream cashel linen. It's really nice. Honestly, as lovely as a lot of hand-dyed fabrics are, honestly, personally, I prefer the just good old plain linen. Raw linen preferred, although this cream is lovely and it's perfect for this project. But I think 90 to 95% of the time I would go for a raw linen over a hand-dyed fabric. I'm glad I have the few hand-dyed pieces that I do, and I'll find something to do with them or something to stitch on them, but I think I'm a basics gal. To each their own, eh? Speaking of, the fabric for my Mira came. I'm not sure when I'm going to start my Mira. It's going to be soon. I need to, I need to make a photocopy of the pattern because I definitely want a working copy. But I'm going to be stitching it on 32 count Belfast linen in flax. Really, really nice. This is a 18 by 27 inch piece. It's all folded up. But I think that's going to be lovely. So that's the new pretties I have right now. I showed on my New Year, so unprepared, my New Year's WIP update and stuff video. Here is where we are on Master and the Macabre. Very happy with the progress here. I did the roof while binge watching the original Star Wars, and that was really perfect because I got to banter with my partner and my kiddo, and it was really mindless. And honestly, the roof is what was giving me the most anxiety about this project. Just not even anxiety, just like, oh god, so much solid color, and it's a gray, but it got done, so happy about that. That's what I got for right now. Perhaps this evening I will show you how much I got done on Romantic Moonlight. If not within the next couple of days, I'll film something. I was also thinking I'd go around the house and try to stalk the cats, because that's something people do in these vlogs, is like, here, look at my fur balls. And maybe, I don't know. What else? I finished listening to Mr. Mercedes, and I enjoyed it very much. Stephen King did a pretty good job of giving the whole, like, hard-boiled detective genre a new modern twist, and I enjoyed it. I listened to it because it's just nice. I love audiobooks. I mean, I love just like sitting down with a book, but sometimes it's just nice to have someone read you a story. So that's cool. So if you like mysteries and you like Stephen King, I'd suggest Mr. Mercedes. And currently, I'm listening to, I'm almost finished with it actually, because it's a quick one, The Hellbound Heart by Clive Barker, which was the inspiration for the Hellraiser films. Which honestly, I think I've only ever seen the first one, and that was like 15 years ago, so. But I dig it. Like, I like Barker's the story's what, like 25, 30 years old, but I like the, it's like, it's fresh horror. It's something new. It's not the, your usual run-of-the-mill ghosties or ghoulies or goblins or slashers. So, that's fun. I'm probably going to finish that today because it's a quick one. And the audiobook is only like 3 hours long, so. And after that, I'm not sure what I'm going to listen to. I have some Kurt Vonnegut. I have some Dostoevsky. I've got some options. I think I've got, I don't know. I'll have to look tomorrow and see what my options are. Audiobook wise. Other than that, that's how my year's going. Pretty good so far. Yeah. That's what I got. Happy New Year. Hey, it's 10 o'clock on Wednesday, January 6th. I got a fair amount of stitching done on Romantic Moonlight. I hate calling it that because I'm making this for my kid. And eventually I'll talk about why now. If you're familiar with the kids' book, Guess How Much I Love You, with, she was given that book, like, she was maybe a week old when someone got that book for her. That was, like, one of her very first Hanukkah presents ever. But it's about these two rabbits and, a kiddo rabbit and a daddy rabbit, and they're kind of doing the one-upping each other on how much they love each other, and it's really cute. The last line is, "And I love you right up to the moon and back," and we say that to her. And she said that to us, although she keeps saying things like, you know, as she's gotten older, like, "Well, I love you all the way up to Pluto and back." I'm like, oh, that's far. And lately it's been like, "Well, Mommy, I love you up to 100 million thousand Plutos." So it's getting kind of silly. But anyway, it's for her. And anyway, so this is what I got done thus far. My Avengers needle minder from Minding My Minders. So, quick stitch. And finished listening to The Hellbound Heart yesterday. Liked it very much. Quick. So now I don't have anything to listen to. I think today I'm gonna watch Flosstube while I stitch a little bit. And yeah. Got some new books to read too. Got Being Mortal by Atul, Gawande. Heard many good things. And sort of a work-related reading. I got Ina May's Guide to Childbirth. Ina May Gaskin is like this awesome midwife, and she's written a ton of books. she's really cool. She's this little old lady, and she's got big gray Princess Leia buns a lot of the time. And she lives on this commune in Tennessee that she and her husband helped found, like, 40 years ago. And they have a birth center there. So. Yeah. So that's the physical reading. Excuse me, the physical reading pile. Other than that, I've got some tea, nothing fancy, just English breakfast with almond milk, and, yeah, that's where I am right now. I'm gonna make soup for dinner tonight. Maybe I'll film a little bit of that. Maybe. Anyway. Okay, so, yeah, that's my plan for today. Hey, it's Friday, January 8th. Haven't really felt compelled to film anything this week, or for much of this week. But I have been stitching a little bit on Romantic Moonlight, and I finished the text. So now I just have to do the moon. And there are a few tiny, just single stitches here and there that I think I'm going to teach myself pin stitch for. And then there's some back stitching. So, yeah, it's a fun little stitch. And, yeah. So that's all I have for right now. I will try to do something over the weekend, maybe. But yeah. Romantic mood night. Howdy. Vlogging from my car in a parking lot. Don't worry, I'm not. Well, I think you can see other cars. You can probably tell it's a parking lot. Yeah, I just got done at the gym. Because my New Year's resolution, which I make very loosely and I don't do them every year because I think, just in my experience and in watching other people with them, New Year's resolutions can be a very soul-sucking thing. And that's not where anyone needs to be. Anyway, I decided I was going to try to get exercise somewhat regularly this year. Make it a habit. Trying to play really fast and loose with it, be kind to myself, blah blah blah. But yeah, I had it, so I went to the gym. But yeah, so next I have to go buy some cat food before the furballs riot, and then I've gotta prep a new start. My last new start of January. My last new start for a while, actually, because then I should have, like, enough for a rotation. Yeah, so I'll show you that when I get home. Haha. And I'm home again. Yeah. So, here is the progress I made on Romantic Moonlight. So the next time this thing comes up in the rotation, it's gonna be finished, like within 2 days. So, yeah. I really like it. It's a nice quick stitch. It's, the colors are not usually colors I gravitate to, so it's kind of fun that way. You know, it's just kind of new. And yeah, so you fell on the floor. Okay, when am I gonna start today? Scared. It's Mira day. Hey, what the hell day is it? It's Tuesday. I know it's Tuesday. What day? January 12th. Tuesday, January 12th. I started my Mirabilia, and I got like 12 stitches. I'm really scared, guys. I'm scared I'm gonna mess it up. Blah, 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 blah. You wanna see? Also, this is a lot of fabric. Like, I don't know what I'm gonna do with all the fabric. Aside from, you know, stitch on it, but it's a big piece. So can you see? That is what I got done. And I'm trying to psych myself up, so I'm using my Rosie the Riveter needle minder from Minding My Minders. What is this? This is flax. Where did I put it? Is this it? Yes. 32 count Belfast linen in flax. Not a bad neutral. I like it. Yeah, and it's 18 by 27. So it's a huge piece of linen. I've never worked with anything this big. So guys, I'm scared. I can do this, right? I can do this. I can do this. We can do it. I stitched that, got scared, and decided that I can't handle unwieldy fabric and big unwieldy patterns. So I photocopied the pattern because I wanted a working copy. They're so expensive. It's like when I'm done with this, I'd kind of like to pass the pattern on to someone else. And if I do that, I don't want to mark it up. So I photocopied it, and I did it at home. If I had gone to like Kinko's or something, I could have had the same size, but now I've just got a bunch of 8.5 by 11 sheets of paper, but I'll figure it out. It'll be okay. I will just number them. So yeah, not showing you those, obviously. That's kind of what's going on. Yeah. Uneventful. So I'm gonna, since this is Mira's week, I'm gonna work on the Mirabilia. And I'm gonna try and get it done after I get the pattern pages organized. So we'll see what happens. It'll be fine. Yeah. See you later. Hello. It's Wednesday, January. January 13th. I just got done at the gym. And, well, I got home from the gym and I drank some juice and I vegged out for like 10 minutes. And then I realized, oh, right, vlog. So yeah, I'm working on Mirabilia this week. And so far it's going okay, I guess. So I finished a leaf. Can you see? There, I finished a leaf, and then I just decided to count over and start working on part of the woman's skirt. So that's kind of what I'm doing right now. I think I'm gonna just work on the skirt because it feels safe and go from there. It really shouldn't scare me that much. I mean, it's just cross-stitching. I'm gonna do the beading last, and really there's not that much beading, like compared to, say, Mermaid of Atlantis, which I own the pattern for Mermaid of Atlantis, and I own all of the specialty threads for it. I don't know when I'm going to start stitching Mermaid of Atlantis. When Rainbow Stitchery was having their sale, they might still be having their sales. I don't know if they've officially closed, but I just picked up all the specialty threads just because I thought, hey, they're on sale. But I haven't bought the beads. I haven't bought the DMC. I haven't decided what fabric I'm using. What's the point of me talking about Mermaid of Atlantis? Beads. There's a lot of beads in Mermaid of Atlantis. There was no way I was going to do that first, being someone who's never beaded before. Gonna work some more on this today and see where it takes us. Books. At the gym, I'm listening to Shirley Jackson's novel, The Haunting of Hill House, which I had never read before. I've always wanted to. I know they've made a couple of movies of it, which I have not seen. I'm enjoying it. It's kind of literary horror. Well, it feels kind of, I mean, Shirley Jackson is more literary than most in the horror genre, but I like it. I'm really rooting for Eleanor, who's one of the characters who has a lot of anxiety issues, and just in the time and place it was written, she kind of doesn't feel like she can live on her own because she's a spinster. And just, I'm pulling for her so hard. I hope I don't get my heart broken, but you never know. So that's fun. I'm reading a birth book written by Ina Mae Gaskin called Ina Mae's Guide to Childbirth, which I would highly recommend to any pregnant person or anyone who's planning on becoming pregnant, regardless of what kind of birth you're planning to have, whether you want to give birth in your house or you want to give birth in a birth center, or you want to go to the hospital and have an induction and an epidural and all that hospital-y stuff. It doesn't matter. This book will help you and it will educate you about what's going on in your body and what labor is. And education is the most important thing I've found. The more you know about what's going down and what the science is, the less scary it is. I don't know. I could make a whole video of just me recommending birth stuff. But I don't know if there would be much interest in that. Anyway, so that's my day for today. Gonna stitch, and if I remember this evening, I will show you what I accomplished. So. Hey, just so that I don't forget later tonight. So this is what I got accomplished today. Not too much, but then I didn't have as much free stitching time today. But it's over 100 stitches. And as you can see, this is two DMC colors blended in this over here too. And that was kind of fun. Once I figured out what the pattern wanted me to do, that was pretty fun. And yeah, so that is the progress on Autumn in My Garden for today. Yeah, see ya. Hey folks, Thursday, January 14th. I don't have a lot to say today. I'm gonna be cross stitching just to keep my mind occupied, but Alan Rickman, who I have admired since I was 8 years old and first saw him in Robin Hood, Prince of Thieves. I don't recommend letting an eight-year-old watch that movie, by the way. he died. And it's getting to me. So, yeah, I'm not very entertaining right now. But I'll be working on Mirabilia, and I may see which films of Rickman's are streaming on Netflix and give one a watch. I don't own many of his films, unfortunately. I don't own very many movies, but I'm just gonna do some self-care today. It feels weird doing that for someone you've never met. But it hurts. And just gonna go with that. And life goes on. No matter what. For better or for worse. And it's a beautiful day. So I will update you with progress when there's progress. So take care. Okay, this is the progress I made today. It doesn't feel like I got a whole lot done, but then I just kind of was really sad. So, but yeah, it's coming along. I find myself like getting distracted by other parts of the pattern, like planning ahead a little bit, and I don't know if that's wise, if I should just, you know, focus on the task at hand. I don't know, it's kind of hard to explain, but I think it's looking okay. It looks kind of patchworky, and maybe not so pretty right now, but I'm hoping, like, when the rest of the skirt is done, we'll actually be able to see what they were trying to do as far as shading, etc. But, yeah, so far, no major screw-ups, and I'm handling it, so good stuff. Hey folks, it is Friday, January 15th. Life keeps on going. not too much to report today. I'm gonna do a little bit of stitching on Mirabilia when I can. Have not gone to the gym yet today because my partner is working from home today and we thought we'd go together after he has a work conference call. So, yeah, that's kind of, I don't have anything really interesting to mention. Well, I actually have a couple of cool things that I'm probably going to talk about next week because I'm just not in the mood right now. I chose the pattern for the baby blanket I'm making. I think I might have showed that. I don't remember. It's called Cradle Me. It's a nice, it's got some lace, but not like delicate lace, so, and it's knit in a nice squishy weight of yarn, so it's good for a baby. And I ordered some nice spring green yarn from Knit Picks. Excuse me. I was gonna go for something a little more posh, but then I was thinking, like, maybe if I were making it for my baby, I would. But, like, the people who are having this baby are not knitters. I don't think they're terribly crafty. And it's not that I don't think they would appreciate a posher yarn. It's just they're not going to want to take care of a posher yarn, even though it's would be washing machine safe. You know, as a knitter, as someone who appreciates that, you know, I would probably take the extra time because I'm anal retentive about that sort of thing, even when sleep deprived because I have a newborn. But no, I got some Knit Picks superwash wool. I have knit a ton of baby stuff with that in the past. It's super soft. And it's a good, I think it'll make a good fit. So I'm just waiting for that to get here and then I can do a gauge swatch and get that blanket underway. Also here, why don't I just show you, because it's right over here. I started a sock, except, hey, so my last video cut off unexpectedly, and then I got distracted and couldn't make more room on my phone until late last night. And at that point it was like, well, I could vlog some more, or I could play Borderlands 1. Couple of things. Well, first of all, yesterday I said that I had ordered yarn for the baby blanket. It arrived. Hooray. So this is, yeah, Knit Picks. This is Swish DK, which is their superwash wool. In the colorway is called Green Tea Heather, which I thought was perfect for a springtime baby. So I'll start doing a gauge swatch for that soon. And what I was reaching to show you before the video cut off is I started another pair of socks, and I'm being super chill about these. They're basically my travel knitting, board knitting, basic sock recipe from in my head. Come on, stop being tangled. Cast on for what's probably a guy's size sock. So, yeah, nothing too exciting, but it's a nice take-along project for kids' soccer, or waiting in line at the grocery store, or what have you, watching hockey. Yeah. So, progress on the knitting front. Hurrah. And on the Mirabilia front, I got, I don't know, maybe a couple hundred stitches done yesterday. Let's see if you can see. Yeah, that's what got done yesterday. At times it kind of feels like I'm knitting that I'm stitching camo, but oh well. Progress. So hopefully I'll get some time to stitch today and tomorrow. But other than that, it's gonna get taken off the hoop and replaced by Master of the Macabre next week. So that's that. Yeah, today's Saturday. Don't have any huge major plans this weekend. Been doing some tidying up around the house. Yeah. So I will try to film tonight. Just to show you any progress I have made. And I'm probably also going to film a WIP update video and do a tag this weekend sometime. Maybe tonight, maybe tomorrow. I don't know. We'll see. So, see you later. Hey, it's Tuesday, January 19th. Have I done any stitching? No! I wasn't planning on doing anything yesterday because I tend to, as far as vlogging and being on social media and whatever, I tend to kind of take a step back because I think Martin Luther King Day of all days, we should kind of make room for Black voices. So generally, yeah, I just kind of sit and listen and absorb and not throw my hat in the ring because why? And also yesterday, like, I was exhausted. I went to the gym and I came home and I went to sleep and I got up and I ate something and just kind of zombied through the day. But, nah. It has gotten very cold in Philadelphia. And apparently on Friday there might or might not be a big snowstorm. So things might start to suck even more, or they might not. Who knows? But I'm going to start working on Master of the Macabre again today. Going to finish the little thing on top of the roof and then decide where I'm going from there. So, it'll be a surprise. Okay, here's my stopping point for today. As you can see, I finished the little steeples thing up here. And I filled in this bit, and then I started on the window that has the mask of the Red Death. And I just want to point out that I taught myself with the help of some tutorials on YouTube pin stitch. So that is what the single red stitch here is and the single pale blue stitch here. That's pin stitch, my very first two. Pretty easy, actually. If you haven't tried it yet and are intimidated, don't be. You can do it. If I can do it, you can do it. So, yeah, working on this right now. So I think I'll definitely finish this window, and I don't know if I'll do this. I might do these two windows and then fill in house to, like, here. And then go from there. But we shall see what the week brings. But yeah, that's my stopping point for today, and I'm going to spend the rest of the day doing some knitting. Yeah, I said I'd do something interesting today, but instead I'm searching for my cats, because you haven't seen them. This is Andre. Everyone likes him but me. Yeah, you. Yeah, well, you're a jerk. Meow, meow. Yes, yes. He's about 4. All our animals are rescues. All our animals. We have 2. Yes. All right, where's Alex? There she is. This is Alex, and the lighting is terrible because of all the shadows, but this is Alex. She's 14. My partner found her when she was about 5 weeks old in a parking lot in a rainstorm, and Andre's gonna come and just spoil everything because that's what he does. Hey, kitten. But yeah, these are the beasts. You see what he does? All right. Some stitching actually did get done today, although a dismal amount. So yeah, I got the little red mask and I filled in the eyes and I did the nose. Yeah, that's all I got. I did manage to knit a gauge swatch. And it's perfect. That's never happened before. So yeah, those needles with this yarn will make a nice baby blanket, hopefully. So I'll start working on that tomorrow as well. But for now, yeah, that's what got done today. Hey, it's Friday, January 22nd. I'm getting kind of a late start doing crafty stuff because I was out running errands. And I was at the gym and such. But I don't know, I'm feeling pretty good today. So I live in I live in Philly, so we're kind of like in between the mid-Atlantic and the Northeast. But as many of you in the U.S. know, we are potentially gonna get a huge blizzard starting tonight and in all day tomorrow. I don't know how I feel about these things. Like, there's often a lot of panic, especially in major metropolitan areas, because nasty weather can gunk up the works, like public transportation, which a lot of us use, and just access to things, not to mention our homeless population. So I'm kind of hoping that the hype is just hype, but at the same time, we're prepared. We've got enough meals to last through Sunday. We've got our backup heating system ready to go in case the power goes out. We're pretty much set. There's, beer and tea and hot chocolate and coffee, the essentials. So let it snow. But if you live south of me, like if you are in the DC metro area and stuff, please be safe, because I know you guys are going to get slammed. Anyway, yeah, I just hope everyone is safe and warm this weekend, even though by the time I publish this vlog, it'll have passed, but it's what's on my mind right now. So I'm gonna do a little bit of stitching. I didn't get as much knitting. I didn't get any knitting done yesterday, actually. Just shopping and getting distracted. I have to cast on 150 stitches. I cast on 100 and then just life happened. So that will definitely, I will make progress on the blanket this weekend. For now, I'm going to work some more on the Telltale Heart window in Master of the Macabre. I'm gonna watch some X-Files on Netflix and chillax. I never use that word. Why did I use that word? I want to see what I'm drinking. I got some coffee from, there's this awesome locally owned little coffee shop / consignment shop / cafe in my neighborhood. And I'm having a tiny coffee because I've been trying to cut back. Well, no, I have cut back. I very rarely drink coffee anymore. And I stopped at Whole Foods after I went to the gym and I got a green juice. Normally I make my own, but it was convenient. So, yeah. Gonna watch some X-Files, gonna stitch, gonna relax. No worries. So yeah, hopefully I will remember to show you any progress I have made. Excuse me. Hopefully I'll remember to show you any progress that I make today in the stitching and knitting front. Otherwise, I'll catch you later. Hey everybody, it's late Sunday evening, January 24, and yeah, I didn't do any filming this weekend because it was busy. But I just wanted to show you this week's progress on Mastering the Macabre. I got both windows done that I wanted to. I actually just finished up the Telltale Heart. This was... I'm happy to get this done. I had been hoping to maybe get some of the house filled in, but... it's just... it's been a crazy week, and I haven't had as much time to stitch as I'd wanted to, but I'm happy with these, and so this will go away until it's turn again in another 2 or 3 weeks. So, yeah. Onward and ever upward. Hey, it's Tuesday, January 20-something. 26. So I was going to start my rotation, my, you know, the next project in my rotation yesterday, but, well, it was a snow day, like schools were closed and my spouse didn't go to work, and because public trans in Philly is still kind of, at least for folks of us who live a little bit further out, like yesterday, our local train station was still covered in snow, and the office was closed, so it was a work from home day. And I went to the gym and I came home and my body was like, oh, you exercised, now it's time to sleep. Forever. So I didn't get a whole lot done yesterday. I got some knitting done. And of course, because I'm me, it's in the other room. I got like the bottom border of the blanket done, and now I can start the actual lace pattern. I just have to find a pair of 4mm needles that are long enough. They're around here somewhere. I just have to dig. But anyway, today I'm going to try... let's see, the project at hand is... which way had I been holding you? Oh, this way. We're back to Hardanger. Here, I'll just get that. Just move that out the way. There we go. We're back to Hardanger. I'm going to be using this book to help me figure out just what the heck I was doing wrong with blanket stitches last time. And so yeah, I'm gonna work on that for a bit and see what happens. So my goal for this week is to finish the blanket stitching. And if I finish the blanket stitching, I might start the cutting, but that scares me. But it has to get done, so we shall see. But yeah, that is the plan for right now. Today, Tuesday, and I'm probably going to watch some vintage X-Files.
and yeah, chillax for a bit. So yeah, that's the plan for today.
Hey, it's Sunday, January 31st, last day of January, last little installment of this month's blog series. If you made it this far, good on ya. I feel like it's been kind of a boring month, just for you guys. It's been kind of a rough mental health month for me. I've had some pretty nasty anxiety issues, so there wasn't, like, I feel like it was just like, here's my stitching. I will try to do better next month. So I haven't filmed this yet, but if you've made it this far, at the beginning of this video, I did my WIP update and everything, which I'm going to film later today, so you'll see other progress I've made on some things. But just, I wanted to try and end on a bit of a fun note, or at least a different note. So I'm not going to talk about stitching for the next couple minutes. I'm going to talk about, like, skincare. Because I'd been kind of wanting to incorporate, like, lifestyle stuff into the vlog. Crap happened this month, so it didn't really get off the ground. But I was thinking, and I'm not a very high maintenance person, as you can tell, like, my hair's needed a haircut since, like, August. And, you know, my eyebrows get waxed when I remember to do it, which is rarely. And, I don't do makeup, and, but I do live in the Northern Hemisphere. It's winter now, and I struggle with dry skin. Not necessarily on my face, it's my lips and my hands, and my elbows. But I think the elbows are a lost cause. Anyway, I just wanted to kind of share some stuff for those of you who also live in the Northern Hemisphere and it's winter now, and maybe you're struggling with dry skin. If you live in the Southern Hemisphere, hey, it's a leg up for next winter for you. And I'm gonna name drop some brands and stores. They're not endorsing me in any way. This is just what works for me. And the first product I wanted to talk about, I only have like three. The first product I wanted to talk about is from a German company called Veleda. And they have a lotion called Skin Food. And this is actually a small, like, sample size one, but my larger one got lost when I moved. But it comes in a tube, and a little bit goes a very long way. And I actually slacked off on using this, and my fingers have paid the price. Like, I don't know if you can see this awful crack that I got in my thumb. It's actually healing, but, like, I was putting Neosporin and Band-Aids on it all of this week to get it not sore and raw and bleeding. Winter affects usually the tips of these four digits and the backs of my knuckles really badly. And I have found if I use this, once my skin gets better, like when I first started it, I would apply it like three times a day. And once my skin got not horrid, I'd apply it in the morning. Or you could do it in the evening too. I could see how that would work for you. Whatever works for you. It really helps. What is in this? Water, sunflower seed oil, lanolin, sweet almond oil, beeswax, alcohol, glycerin, tricolor extract, hydrolyzed beeswax, sorbitan oil, rosemary leaf extract, chamomile, calendula flower extract, zinc sulfate, and a couple of other essential oils. So there's nothing too crazy in here. And at first it's a little greasy, but if you just keep rubbing it in, I'm gonna take my ring off. But if you just keep rubbing it in, it absorbs into your skin pretty well. So I started using this last winter, because it was just horribly cold and horribly dry, and we were living in our apartment still, and we didn't have a dishwasher, so it was like dishpan hands plus horrible dry weather, and this was a lifesaver. Well, this plus I actually went out to the store and bought some of those bright yellow rubber grandma washing dishes gloves, which I have no shame about because that helped too. But yeah. So I'd highly recommend that. It's not cheap, but it's also not terribly expensive. I have a Whole Foods near me and I purchased it there in their whole body section, and it was like under $8. I'm gonna link the Amazon. Amazon sells it too, and I'm gonna link them because not everyone has a Whole Foods near them. But if you Google it, you might find a store near you that carries it. So that's what I'd recommend for your hands. Let's talk about our lips. Chappy, chappy lips. I recently discovered this. So one of my favorite like cosmetic stores is Lush, which is originally a UK-based company, but they have a lot of stores, I think, worldwide. North America has quite a few. Like if you live near a city, you're not gonna have any problem finding an actual brick and mortar Lush store. Like I live in the Philadelphia area and I think there are three within half an hour of me. There are two in downtown Philly, and there's one about 45 minutes outside of Center City in a giant shopping mall, but that's neither here nor there. Anyway, I can see myself using this all year round, because I have kind of like perma-chapped lips. It's their lip scrubs. I got the mint julep flavor, just because it appealed to me the most. But this is, it's sugar, jojoba oil, vanilla extract, peppermint oil, Tagetes oil, I don't know what that is. So essentially it's sugar, vanilla, and a bunch of essential oils. And what you do is it's a sugar scrub, you know, like you would buy for like rubbing on your bod in the shower. But it's caster sugar, so it's very fine sugar. And I've already done it today, so I'm not going to do it again. But you put some on your finger and you buff your lips with it. And then when you're done, you can just lick it off because it's edible and it doesn't taste bad and it's sugar. So it exfoliates and helps you get rid of all the crusties and dry skin on your lips. You're gonna want to moisturize your lips after you use this. You can use your lip balm/chapstick of choice. Like, obviously, you know, they say, you know, lick off the excess, then apply your favorite Lush lip balm. Well, I don't use Lush lip balms. I use coconut oil. Because I have it in my house, because I use it for cooking and moisturizing my lips. You could also, I'm told, use it as like a deep conditioner for your hair. Not up in your scalp, but like this mess. I have not done that because I don't quite know how, what the process would be. You could probably Google it. Someone has probably done a tutorial about using coconut oil to moisturize your hair. Anyway, what I do once a day, scrub, moisturize with this. It works for me. And the last thing, probably the most helpful thing for just dry skin, chapped lips, general feeling like you're disgusting ever. Water. Drink it. Most people are dehydrated for much of their day. If you don't have to pee once an hour, you could probably stand more good old H2O in your life. And honestly, when I make an effort to stay hydrated, I notice my lips don't feel disgusting. My dry skin is noticeably better. I am less likely to bite someone's head off for no reason. I am less likely to get headaches. We're biological organisms. We need water. So if you don't have the budget for this and this, this was like $10. And it's gonna last a while. You can get, for coconut oil, the most bang for your buck is gonna be to drop $40 on a big old tub, and it will last you a year. At least, I am not making this up. The most bang for your buck is to spring for a larger container. If you can't do that, if you don't have access to coconut oil, if you're like, go away, hippie. You know, I'm a college student, or, you know, I have a fixed income. I don't make a lot of money. I can't drop $10 on some luxe little whatever, and I'm not going to bother with this. Go away, crazy lady. Water. I promise. Trust. Anyway, that's Julicious's little, like, help your skin out and your brain out during winter little PSA. So anyway, thanks so much for putting up with me this month. I'll try to make next month more fun. Did you like this little show and tell? Let me know, because I can do other things and give me ideas for little show and tells you might like to see. But anyway, I hope you had a great start to your year, and I'll see you next month.